It's Monday. I'm unpacking from yesterday. I know I was there for like a long time yesterday, but I only got this much done. Which is more than I thought, actually. It was really distracting because I had a new table neighbor who wasn't new, but new to that like spot. And so it was distracting. She's very chatty, very nice. Very enjoyed it. Yesterday was actually like the first time I made my table fee back, which isn't saying much, but it's nice. I like it. Ow. My rib still hurts. No reason. Everything else pretty much stays in here, I think. Oh, she gave me this shell. She wanted me to keep it in my purse for prosperity. So I'm going to keep it in this bag, I guess. Because this is where I want the prosperity to be. Yesterday was print day, I guess. Sold a couple of leftover cards. I wrote it here. One of the larger prints and like six of the 8x10s. Which isn't like very much. But like I said, I haven't ever made the table fee. Outside of the commissions, of course. But yeah, it was fun. Somebody released by accident, I guess. I hope. Something like 60 helium balloons in the building, so there were balloons just everywhere. And it was really delightful. I find it, that kind of stuff, really whimsical and enjoyable. I like that. So this week, I have to do three things today. I have to pack an order, and I really should send the sketch stage of the Kickstarter book, because people are starting to do it. I don't know why I was sitting on it. And I finally got my space ID for the Pacific Arts Market, which means that I can now make an inventory and plan and pack for that. For this table here, I guess. I think that tables are on sale again this week, so that's good for me. Although, it's not a 6-foot table, it's gonna have to be a 5-foot table, which means I'm gonna have to buy a 5-foot table, which is kind of like a weird shape, but they got it. I'm gonna go to Canadian Tire after dropping my stuff off and hope that I can travel around. What's complicating this though is that our transit system may be shut down this week because the SkyTrain is on strike. If you don't know what SkyTrain is, it's just a rail system that is great and gets you from point A to point B much more efficiently than buses, but that might be shut down. So it's looking like I can take a bus to the other rail system that's not going to be on strike, and that will get me close, and I'll be fine, but it will take me 2 hours to get there. So, and the thing that I hate the most about our transit system is that our tickets are only good for an hour and a half, but it takes significantly longer than an hour and a half to get across the transit system because it's so big. So I don't know why they don't increase it a little bit as they spread out. Like, maybe at least make a ticket good for 2 hours at the least, because everywhere I go that is like outside of a commute, of course, is going to be more than at least 2 hours, or like an hour and 45 minutes or 2 hours to get there. So it's like really freaking annoying that when your ticket is done and you're only like 2/3 of the way through your trip, and if you're lucky you can kind of just coast by and not get fined, or you have to buy a whole new ticket again, which is really annoying. And while I'm complaining like an old man about things that don't matter, I think that for 2020 YouTube should finally get an arts category. That would be great. I don't know why they don't have an arts category. I pretty much just copied Bailey in terms of like putting my art videos in. I think it's like how-tos and style, which is not even remotely like what art videos are. Like, there's like no art video classification system. So it's like, so yeah, I gotta plan out what kind of things I will bring to this, but I think I might be generous. I'm going to plan out the inventory first and then work out what I can physically carry. I just don't know if my idea of an inventory is going to be their idea of an inventory and if it's going to work, so that'll be fun. I guess I have to count all my prints now. Again. So, it's at the point now where I have my item, no, my space ID for the Pacific Arts Market. So I was thinking of holding on to my flea market inventory for online sales. So like, I'm having this issue where I'm looking at like the mock-up price list. So like, if it were me, I'm assuming that they're not going to tell me what's selling day to day. I'll probably just have to go and count myself, I guess. I have no idea how it's going to work. I don't know if they send emails about things that sold, like even tiny things. Don't know. With that in mind, like, I would be tempted to just have my fat stack of prints. Like, okay, say that I have 50 pieces of these or something. Assuming that I'm not going to know the quantity of each style at any given time because I won't be aware of sales, maybe. I would be tempted to just say, oh, I have 50 prints, and then I will make them one item code. So this will be item code 001, and there's 50 copies of them or something like that. The mock-up thing, because they send me an example of their price list, because they have to use it, so that they know what to charge for stuff. This says, item number 001 is something like a picture of this, the city, blah blah. It's called Quartz Vancouver. So it says 8x10 print of blah 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 times 5. So it would say that I have 5 copies of this. So like, if I had 50 pieces total, but I had 5 styles, 10 copies each, this wants me to put, I have item 001 is picture of Quartz Vancouver times 10, and then picture of public market times 10 would be product number 2. That makes perfect sense. I don't really need to go that specific because I'm not gonna know, it's not gonna help me, but like, I can do that. But then I go into like the move-in instructions and it says fill in your item number starting with 001, etc. Each item needs to have its own number. If you have multiples of the same item, they must all be listed separately with their own item number. If you have more than 25 of the same item, let me know. So like, that makes it seem like I need to list it as in, okay. So like, I think normally I would say, okay, this is one item 001. Print of OPA thing times 3 pieces, which is all I have left, by the way. But in the instructions, it's going to say, like, no, each one has to be 001, 002, 003. And that means I'm going to have 50 product codes for one item type for no reason, because they're all the same item and they're all the same price. So I'm going to go with the mock-up, but just having those words saying like each item number, even if they're multiples, has to have their own number, like, that's so bizarre. And I'm so confused. And I have a really bad feeling about the transportation part of this. Like, there are so many things that I would love to put on the table, but because I have to sell so much in order to be able to cover the rent. Like the calendars, I literally only have like 3 or 4 calendars left. So am I gonna like hang on to most of them to ship out? But then if nobody orders online, maybe they'll buy them there. Maybe I'll just take a couple. That's gambling, I guess. Okay. This has taken me so long. So for all of my items, I need them to be labeled with my table number and the price. And so, oh my god. It took me a while to figure out a way to make it in nice little columns. And then hopefully I got this right. So each style of print is going to be a product number. So I've got like four of number one, and now I'm going to have to cut all these labels out and stick them on the back of everything. It doesn't look like much, but I don't know if I'd even be able to carry this many items. It's taking me way too long, like several hours, I think, to figure out the inventory sheet and make the labels and now print them out, and I'm surprised by how long it's taking. But I'm sure it's still shorter than handwriting it. Oh my god! I went to print the list as well, and it's like on also label paper. This is the second time today this has happened! I don't know how I'm accidentally putting one extra label sheet every time. I don't get it. Where'd you get it from? They're both labels, right? I only put two in there. Why is there three? This doesn't look like very much. Of course, like, the stuff that I'm taking, I'm four of those paintings as well. That's the one thing I'm worried about, because I'm not sure how to transport it. But yeah, even, like, just the prints are kind of heavy, so I don't know. So it's Tuesday, and I'm pre-packing for tomorrow, just to see, make sure. I don't want to have any surprises. And also, I want to know what kind of display things I'm going to need to get. So I managed to fit a ton of things in here, surprisingly. The one benefit to this compared to like the flea market is that I don't have to bring lunch or a lot, like some of the display stuff that I bring, like this extra bag. I'm not gonna have to bring these poles or anything. I might take this though, if I can manage to take this. In this backpack, I managed to fit all of these things pretty much. Like, of course, these are all prints, so they all went into one folder. I have the other large prints in there, tucked in, calendars. All of these are teeny tiny little books that I put in a box that is just sitting on top. So I have three of these and one that's round, so I managed to actually fit two of these in there. They're not like, I will have to be kind of careful because they're not padded. I guess I don't have to bring this one, but I kind of want to because this painting is just really popular, so it would make sense to bring it. In fact, I might be more likely to bring this one than this one. So a lot of this stuff I'm not going to need, and the SkyTrain is not closing down, although I still kind of want to go the other route anyway because it's more spacious. I'm actually getting nervous, question mark. Oh. So I am pretty much ready to go, I guess. Today's moving day for the art gallery thing. I managed to get a bunch of stuff in this bag. There's a painting here and all of my display items, blah, blah, blah. It's kind of heavy. That one's also going to be kind of heavy. Yes. Shit. So all in all, probably have about 40 pounds of stuff going with me. It's going to be exactly like the flea market, except this time it's not going to be 5:30 in the morning. I think I might have a chance to get on one of those nice brand new double-decker buses, so I'm very excited about that. And that will take me to a train that is much larger and wider, so it's significantly more spacious inside. A normal person would take a completely different route and then take an express bus to my destination, but the express bus gets so full, I don't want to deal with that kind of stress, to the point where I'm actually considering just walking from the train station to my destination, and it's a 22 minute walk, and I'm gonna regret it. Especially since yesterday I have this like pinched nerve in my neck, so I'm already sore, so that's gonna suck. And like I have to go buy a table. I have to like drop off my stuff and then immediately go run and find a 5-foot table. So that's gonna be another like heavy lifting, but at least I go home empty-handed. Unlike the flea market where I have to do it twice in one day. Yeah. I'm lost in this giant canyon tire and they don't even have it in stock. Ew. Back home, my phone was dying. I kept getting so lost at the Canadian Tire because it's the biggest and most confusing Canadian Tire I've ever been to. And like carrying stuff was worse than I really expected. I guess it was pretty much as bad as I expected. And I was only able to get the 4-foot table, which unfortunately was also only 2 feet deep, because normally tables are like 6x3. And so I had to get a 5, but they couldn't find the 5s at the store. And the bus that I jumped on randomly didn't actually go very far. I only took it a couple of blocks. But, and, you know, I had a dream last night that my first day there was very prosperous. But in reality, I'm sort of not really feeling, like, good about it. So I doubt that I will stay there past January, and I'll probably go back to the flea market. But I only really did it because I wanted to try something new and something good, and honestly, like, there's so much good artwork at that arts market that I just, it would be harder to sell my stuff when there's so much good stuff there, is what I'm trying to say, compared to like the flea market where I'm literally the only artist there. This one, but I do feel like at least I'm trying. I'm trying something new and something big, something risky, so that's all you can do, right? Even if it doesn't work out, at least I did something. I'm practicing sketching people, because that's the theme of the Patreon this month, is faces. So I'm just sketching some random pictures I have around the house. I don't take a lot of pictures of people, so it's, I don't have a lot to work with, but yeah. This weekend on Sunday, the arts market is having a, oh my god, that was right in your eye, having a eggnog and cake party thing. I'm really excited about it, but I'm actually, like, I'm still really sad that I'm not going to be at the flea market. So stupid, but oh well. Maybe I'll go to the morning meetup in Richmond first, so that it's almost kind of the same, and then go. I don't know. Oh, I think he spotted me. Oh, he's mad. But still sitting there. It's like prime viewing spot here. Why? Why is this squirrel staring at me? What is happening?